Hello. Today I wanna tell you a folklore of Indonesia entitled Batu Batangku. That means split stone. Once upon a time, in a village of Indragiri Hilir, Riau, lived a widow who grew her two children. The first daughter was named Dian, the second son is Ucin. Mak Minah had to find the money by collecting and selling the firewood in the jungle and sell it to the market every day. They were in a poor condition. Mak Minah had to go to the jungle after cooking for her children and came back when the sun set. Her hard working was not balanced with their children's bad attitude. They used to eat such a fish, beef and chicken. It was impossible because to buy all, but she was used to suggest them to be patient and ask them help to collecting the firewood. But both of them never do. They just know playing and playing every day. Mak Minah was so sad and did not know what she should do to her children. She loved both of her children, although they had bad attitude. One day, Mak Minah went to the river on the morning. Then she came from the river bringing a big fish. Then she cooked it for dinner. She thought her children would be very happy with tonight's dish. Then she came out for a while to take some vegetables. How shocked she was! The house was very messy and untidy. Moreover, her children had eaten the food, all of the food. They don't even leaving a little of the food. In the evening, her children was busy in playing again. Mak Minah was so angry and went to the Batangkup stone sadly. She's singing and crying to the Batangkup stone. Oh, Batangkup stone! Oh, Batangkup stone! I can't live longer in this world. I can't live with my naughty children. Please, please just swallow me. Please help me. Mak Minah asked Batangkup stone to swallow her because she can't live again with her naughty children. The Batangkup stone cracked and swallowed her body. It was only a little of her hair that still appeared. Knowing their mother was not home, the children went to Batangkup stone. They were sad looking their mother, swallowed by the stone. Mak Minah's children saw the incident. They came closer the stone, then they cried and hoped that their mother would come back again. They promised to be good children who loved their mother. But it was too late. That magic Batangkup stone will never, never ever open, and they will never see their mother forever after.